crack cocaine destroyed our community. And it became an epidemic. Crack babies, grandmothers selling their house to get this drug. I played a part in destroying Compton because of the amount of drugs I had. Back then, I knew I was breaking the law, but I didn't know the effect that cocaine or crack would have on an individual. It's not one person that used to hang with me that escaped going to prison or get shot. I'm Chico Brown, I'm from Compton, Corner Pocket Crips. Most people nowadays want to say they from Compton because they think it's cool to be from Compton. It's fashionable. But you wasn't from Compton when all this shit was happening.
People are not invested in seeing Compton as a human place. They're invested in seeing it as a place of death and dying and black chaos, and that's it. But it's also a place that has people that are family, that are trying to care for one another, that are trying to make space for themselves. That's not how the world has become affixed to understanding this place.
Where others might look at, oh, this place is dangerous, it's got a reputation, I look at a fertile field where you can make something blossom.
Compton is the motherland, it's the home turf.
It was the all-American dream for a lot of people like my parents, you know.
Compton in the 50s was probably 90% Caucasian. President Bush's son was born there. They lived in Compton for a period of time. Black people coming to Compton because they wanted a better life for their family. African Americans that was doing well purchased a house in Compton. Moving from Watts, moving to Compton was a step up. But shit changed. Quick. If you go back in the 60s and 70s in Compton, man, there wasn't no drugs, like, there wasn't no cocaine. The gangs came. Cocaine to become an epidemic. The Crips started first. It's a little street Compton called Piru Street. There used to be the Piru Street Boys, and they just end up the night with the Bloods in L.A. Going to Compton parades, I began to notice the colors was really, okay, if you're from here, you got to represent this. We come from the same kind of family. We went to the same school, but I'm willing to kill you because your parents moved over that side of the street. My parents moved on this side of the street. You got Uzis, you got every fucking gun you can possibly imagine. Everybody had an AK from every neighborhood. It's drive-bys every day. I got involved with, you know, the neighborhood. You know, I never joined a gang, the gang just joined me. At that time, I didn't even think it was a problem. I just thought it was me hanging out with my friends. I realized it was a gang when I got shot when I was 12.
We got a long history, and the history still today. That's the craziest part about it.
Yeah, man, I met Tone. I was 8 years old. Tone in the game before me, so of course he gonna look out for me. Like 17, 18, about to go to my prom. Like, man, I ain't got no car, man. I need a car, man. Let me use the Benz. He's like, Cheek, take the Benz.
Once I gave him that 500 SL and told him to go to the prom, you know, and he seen how that lifestyle was, you know, he chose to, you know, to do, you know, the American way, you know what I mean? Our way.
I was making $100,000 a day. You know, I make $80,000 like it was nothing. So I said, you ready for this? He's like, yeah, I'm ready. So I gave him a key and said, I'm gonna see what you gonna do. The next thing you know, he was like, I need three, I need four.
I made a lot of money, man. Like suitcases, $300,000, $400,000, like three or four of them a week.
I started feeling bad because I seen the effect it was actually really doing to people, but the money was coming in so much, I was saying to myself, you know, so if you stop, you know all this has been the end also.
Tone ended up getting caught, so I ran for a couple of years. The first day I came back to Compton, I got arrested. You know, when I went to prison, I found out that we can't get along, Crips and Pirus. We don't have to kill each other in the street. Like, damn, man, we can't be friends. Only thing you say cuz and I say blood. it got to be a way where we can come together and start working together. If we can do that, we can solve a lot of the problems that's going on. Once I came home, it was like over for me. I just wanted to tell dudes that was on either side, man, look, we can't continue to live this life, man. I started a program called Ex-Contracts. This is dudes who went to prison. This is dudes from either side, Crips or Blood. I put them together and start rehabbing houses in Compton. Because I knew that they learned a skill in prison. It may be tile setting, painting, roofing, plumbing, whatever it may be. I'm like, man, I'm going to put y'all together and let's see how this shit worked. It worked. Hey, look at this. Nobody even know Compton got a golf course, dog. It's a real shit.
Man, I feel like Tiger Hood right now. Let's go play some more golf or something. You know what I'm saying? Yeah.
Crips and Pie Rules was on this golf course. It's a whole bunch of murders that went on with these dudes out here. These G's, these are people who've been there in the trenches. But now, man, we putting down that and picking up a hammer and rebuilding the city that we fucked up, man.
There you go, man. There you go, man.
We all know how to use a hammer. We all know how to paint. Most of us learned that in jail. All of us couldn't get no job, man. None of us. City won't hire, state won't hire, because we all got felons. So I could create a job. Like, let's create something that works.
There's still people in jail. They ain't never come home over there. There's people in the graveyard. They never come home from there. And we got an opportunity to save some other people's lives. We in the hood to know how we're looking. We ain't passing no guns out. We need to like start out here. We need to pass some hammers out.
Let them
build their own neighborhoods up too.
You already know we don't do it. Ain't nobody else gonna do it.
Ain't no question, man. And I just wanna have this meeting with y'all. We're gonna start one of our first projects next week. You know, coming back to Compton with my contractors, I wanted to just give back and renovating some buildings that I feel that was just in terrible condition. I have $500,000 that I'm working with that I raised, you know. So I picked 3 to 4 projects. And I said, I'm gonna do this. We walking through Compton Boulevard. This is downtown Compton.
Right.
Empty.
Look at this, man.
Rows of empty buildings, man.
Yeah.
My vision of what Compton could be, man, it's gonna be like people getting along, like striving together to make this a better place.
Look at this. This boarded up right here. One of these used to be, what is it, store back in the days?
Yeah.
Compton was popping. Everything was functioning.
That used to be the bank right there, that big old building.
There used to be the bank that burnt down. Yeah, right.
That was the bank.
Right.
It's hard for a kid to concentrate on education when he got to go through each neighborhood of gang violence. So we got to make it safe for them kids to even study in school.
When we was coming up, we had a center to go in there. We get out of school, we going in there playing pool or whatever. When they took that away, I knew it was over with because that was saved our lives, bro. When the sports program went away, we went away. It's very important to get that recreation back.
This is the famous Jackie Robinson Stadium, dog. This is where we played at. It's history, man. This is the park right here. A lot of professionals came up out of here. Even Daryl Strawberry, man. The park actually kept a lot of people out of trouble. Look at it, it ain't even being used now. Derek is a contractor, and I bet a few years ago, like 4 or 5 years ago.
This is supposed to have a cap on the end all the way across. They just need to be power washed underneath, cleaned up, bolted down really good.
His commercial license and that he don't have his ties in Compton, so we automatically hit it off.
And these poles are in really bad condition. We just need to sand those down really good.
See, like the wood underneath of this is broken.
That's a hazard.
There is some repair work that's gonna have to happen.
When I think about saving Compton, I'm talking about having programs where these kids can go somewhere to get a meal, or go somewhere where they need help with their homework, where the literacy problem can be helped. One of them was Cynthia Nutt Building, which she runs a youth center in Compton.
You're at Sylvia Nutt Angels, my nonprofit organization here to help the youth. I used to gang bang. I'm going to say I played Russian roulette because I could have been dead. I decided to come back and clean up what myself, my homeboys started, you know.
The building is really like terrible conditions. Didn't have a restroom, no running water. What up,
Seth? That rack.
Oh, shit.
Y'all need to get somebody to handle.
What the hell?
Yeah.
Goddamn. I came to him one day and told him, look, I want to help you. Like, I feel you and what you're trying to do, but if you had a better facility, I'm sure you have more kids.
This is the area between the two columns that we were looking to open up with a computer lab, both sides.
That's what you guys are gonna do, right?
Based on the conversation we had. So now if I'm off base.
Way off.
I'm way off? Chico is way off.
Chico way off, because my plans was for like a boxing ring, a kitchen, and a studio. That's my plans.
Based on what I told you, is this feasible? That's what I'm like, you know, is this something I can do?
No.
No, why?
How much would something like this cost? That's my question to you.
More than the current budget. Much more.
It's not about me, you, and nobody else. It's about these kids, keeping them off the streets and safe. This one-year-old baby could have been here instead of there where she got shot in the head, you know?
We can ask for all this. We can, you know, I can, look, make some calls and try to get the money to do this.
I want a safe haven. I want somewhere where parents can say, I know where my kid is at. And in order for me to have a safe haven, the things that I know that I need, then it's going to happen.
Just make it happen.
Right. Right.
This was Mr. Presto Printing. That's how it started. This was like the dark room where my father did all his development and stuff.
Yeah. And you ain't gonna believe my plans, what I want to do to this building, Calvin. This is, you know.
What you want to do, man?
And I want to build a recording studio. You know, you could talk of that shit like straight out of Compton, but they could call that straight out of Torrance because there wasn't no studio in Compton. We're talking about some real straight out of Compton, where these kids can go to a studio in Compton. I want to turn this building into something special for the kids can come back.
I've known Chico all my life. Chico was like my little brother. He was like my little brother. We were actually just like family. Chico went to, I call it a dark side, you know, and I went towards the light. I became a law enforcement officer and later a minister. So I went that way and Chico went way dark.
So how much space are you looking at? This space?
Bigger. This is might be perfect. What'd you think?
I think this is an awful lot of work. We've exceeded the budget. We gotta bring this into focus. We are not going to be able to refurbish, do a tenant improvement on the entire building.
I'm not gonna come in here and do the building halfway. My word means everything to me. If I tell this guy, like, this is what I'm gonna do, I have to do it. I'm not going halfway.
Okay. This is just motivation.
The kids from Compton always get short-changed.
But we're not, but this
everything
is just
we do, they get short-changed. They get to always get half of everything. They get half of the book. They get all the old stuff. Why? Why, man? Why in our community we gotta go for that? Man, it's not fair. It's not fair to the kids.
If we don't have money, we can't do it. That is just that simple.
I have to find a budget somewhere, man. The budget was way too much. I didn't have that much money. So all the buildings that I'm talking about are all city-owned properties. So for me, I thought I would just go to the city to get approval.
It's gonna be 10 foot deep by 5 foot wide.
Okay.
We're gonna frame this full height all the way up.
Okay.
But we're gonna drop these ceilings in here to 7'6".
Okay.
I told the mayor, and the mayor was on board, like, okay, let's do it.
I think people, they're tired of status quo. Mm-hmm. We're ready for change.
And it takes people working together.
That's right.
And that really have like-minded vision and a real love for the community, because there should be no question whether or not good things can come into the city or whether or not people can build up the city.
You had to do a proposal and go in front of the city council. This should be a slam dunk. Good afternoon, Chico. We destroyed this city. We want to come back and help what we destroyed. And if anybody, you guys know me, I'm the person who went to prison with Rick, with the CIA, the government, all that stuff. So I feel responsible for doing some of this stuff. It was a total of 5 council members. Each council member represents a district in Compton. All 4 city council members in the vote with the mayor, they have to vote on it. All I need is you guys give us an opportunity, give these Crips and Pirus a chance to come back to their city, what they destroyed, and help.
Chico is trying to give back. He's trying to go forward, but at the same time, we're still in a world that's evil.
when I would do good, evil is always present.
You know,
but I've been calling you.
Nobody gonna come in your neighborhood and talk about they ain't no gangbanger. They ain't gonna respect your gangbanger. It's the same shit.
But it's me though. It's me. I've been doing this for three.
You ain't never talked to me about this. I don't know nothing.
But it ain't got nothing to do with political. But I'm saying to you, I've been doing this on my own.
Because it requires the vote of the city.
I'm thinking, what the fuck is this about?
That's what you get for fucking Asia.
This one don't get along with the mayor, then that one don't like the mayor, the mayor don't like this. This is political shit.
This is her whole project. She ain't got nothing to do with this.
She does not have nothing to do with this project.
I've known you longer than her or any of these people up here. When you start buddying up with her, you start treating me fucked up. You did.
That ain't true.
Petty politics. You be my friend and then you get some of this shit passed. Really?
Sometimes it ain't what you do, it's who you associate with, right? You know that better than me, Chico. You know that better than me. I wouldn't support that motherfucker to eat shit.
This is what you're doing to the kids in Compton? Because you want me to be your friend and not her friend? Man, this is the worst. Last week, I went to the city council to get approval of the properties that we're doing in the city. I went up there and presented myself and told them who I was and what I was doing, and I wanted to do some buildings in Compton. They looked at me like I was fucking crazy.
They'd rather cut their nose off to spite their face to say no just because another person came up with it.
It went bad in that motherfucker.
Well, look, you know what we need to do? We need to make it good.
So I go back, submitted paperwork again, 2 or 3 months passed. And they said, we're gonna put you on the agenda and we're gonna vote on it. And I'm happy about it because I'm like, this finally can get done.
On Tuesday, if they say no, that we are jumping ship and we are moving to the private sector so we can get it locked down and get it done.
And for me, it's not about me helping these guys. It's about them helping the city and helping themselves. This is not Chico game. This is what I was sent to do. To come back to my community. They said I destroyed the city. So I'm here to give back. This is all I got to give. This community right here, all these people. You can deny me, but don't deny them. Thank you.
I'm gonna cast my vote, and if anybody wanna know why I voted the way I voted, you can ask me, or you can ask Chico, and he can tell you. So, my vote on this item is no.
Councilperson
Yavetz?
No.
Thank you. Yes. Yes. Thank you. Unfortunately, you're not the first team of people from Compton that wants to come back and invest that were told no by this city council.
You up there representing the city of Compton, but you don't give a shit about them kids. Oh, the shit about these dudes, ex-Crips and Pied Rouges, who was involved in stopping the violence and rebuilding their city. It's a personal reason, because y'all don't like the mayor, or y'all don't like me. That's the only thing I can come up with. At the end of the day, it's the kids who are gonna suffer. For me, man, I'm done with the city, man. I'm gonna find private buildings. I'm just done with this. It doesn't make sense to me. Don't even worry about getting on the agenda no more. I ain't done. Y'all don't even worry about Chico Brown. I'm not doing nothing no more for the city. It's a wrap. I've moved on. I don't need the city approval to do the properties that I'm gonna do now. When people say we can't do this, we're not gonna let the city council control what we're doing in this city. It's our city. It's bigger than us. So we gotta continue, man, no matter what nobody says. It's about helping these dudes, man. The whole thing about this shit, that we gotta work, man. We gotta get the job done. We gotta do this shit right. We gotta be on time. We only get one shot at this shit, man.
Everybody still ready to roll? For real, for real.
Here's their opportunity to have that second chance. It was them that wanted to come and rebuild Compton. Compton is not giving them a second chance. They're giving Compton a second chance.
We lift this day up to you. We thank you. In the Father's name, amen. Now let's go get it. Woo! We set the tempo today.
I did more work today than I've seen people do in a month.
Chico Brown can actually affect change because he is this community. The reason why he's alive is that he has a calling on his life. That's why he's not dead.
Some of us made it, some of us didn't. The way we lost people, it's not nothing cool about that, bro. It was just a part of life.
Now he has to fight through all the darkness that still exists in the world.
My goal is to continue to raise money and to rebuild the city. I need to do this fundraiser ASAP.
He's not one of those guys that just talks about it. He is about it.
ASAP. It's always ASAP with Chico.
He perseveres. He stays focused. And if you keep putting it out there in the universe long enough, someone hears it. Someone listens. And stuff happens.
This is real. It's a real opportunity. Just make it happen.
Yes.
The people of the city of Compton want it. Like, they want a youth center that these kids can go to. They want to play baseball at Gonzalez Park. They want these dudes to come together, working together, building a community.
You got the biggest heart in the world, and you are endeared to do what it is you say you want to do.
I'm not going to give up. My whole mission is to give back. My whole mission is to get these dudes straight. It ain't nothing else. We'll make this happen, bro.
All right, baby.